Here's your business brief. Jobless claims actually ticking downward. This according to the Labor Department report out earlier today. Here, take a look at the numbers. First time jobless claims coming in at 684,000 for the week. Now, that's the lowest since the beginning of the pandemic. And it's also well short of what was expected. Dow Jones forecasted about 735,000. The decline from the week prior is also pretty stark. That's down from 781,000. Continuing claims also trending downward, coming in just shy of 3.9 million. That is opposed to the 4 million that was expected. Meanwhile, some of America's biggest tech giants testified in Washington over their role combating misinformation. The CEOs of Facebook, Google, and Twitter appeared in front of the House Energy and Commerce Committee earlier this afternoon. Facebook touted their efforts to remove hateful content from the platform. They say they've removed 250 white supremacist groups. Zuckerberg also weighed in on the controversial Section 230 of the Communications Decency Act. He said that rather than holding platforms accountable, social media giants should be assessed on their systems designed to catch misinformation. Meanwhile, Google's CEO is concerned that the reforms could hurt them. Twitter CEO Jack Dorsey also discussed their efforts. This includes a new program that will allow users to add more context to the information they believe is misleading or false. Some good news for small businesses. The Small Business Administration is set to expand its loan program for businesses affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. The maximum loan amount will be $500,000. That's up from $150,000. The timeline is also set to expand that to 24 months, and that's an increase from 6 months. The changes will take effect April 6th. Now, the latest in the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic, DoorDash is stepping in to help. The food delivery service has partnered with two test kit companies to provide at-home rapid tests. This will be available in select cities, including Baltimore, Chicago, Cleveland, Dallas, Denver, Minneapolis, and Phoenix. Now, the tests are a little costly. The Vault test runs at $119, and the Everlywell test runs at $109. Luckily, you may be eligible for insurance reimbursement. Disney Plus is about to get a little bit more pricey. Starting tomorrow, the cost of a subscription will hike up $1. That will bring the price up to $8 a month. Annual subscriptions will also see a jump, but this by $10 from $70 to $80 a year. Subscriptions surged well past 100 million this month, far earlier than what was expected. And that's your business brief. I'm Andy Hirschfeld in New York.